Greetings, my fellow classmates, and good evening. I'm Master Rohan Ghate, here to present my presentation on the topic inflation theory. Basically, my aim is to explain this theory and also prove that seemingly complicated and intriguing theory can be actually explained by almost no math and simplest diagrams ever. Okay, so that's why it is not going to be a very mathematical kind of presentation, but a simple presentation. But the takeaway from this presentation, I hope you will like it very much. Okay. So with that said, let me just give you a simple background of the inflation theory. So in simple words, inflation theory was discovered by Sir Alan Guth in 1980s. And the aim was to address different paradoxes and dilemmas regarding the creation of the universe. But in this particular presentation, I will be specific to the two basic dilemmas, such dilemmas regarding the creation of the universe. First of them is the horizon problem, and the second is flatness of the universe, or the flatness problem. So this was a bit about a history. Now, I know in such a brief presentation, I couldn't give all of the theories, but I will try my best to regard all that I have here today. Great. Now, starting with the inflation theory, I would like to tell that the cosmic inflation is the event that happened at the 10 raised to 32th part of a second after the Big Bang. So in this diagram too, you can see that this is basically a diagram given, official diagram given by the scientist. And you can see that here 10 raised to minus 32 seconds, they are saying. And the cosmic inflation is the event they have displayed in this particular background. Also, you may notice origin of the fluctuation word over here. Why is that word given? So here comes a new concept, breaking of symmetry. So this breaking of symmetry is one thing which triggered the inflation, of the universe to happen. Basically, the breaking of symmetry means the breaking of various forces. Now, you might have heard in your earlier classes that scientists are behind the discovery of the grand unified theory, okay, GUT. It is a theory which can explain all the theories at once, okay, in a singular equation, or all the laws of physics in a singular theory, in a single theory. So for that to happen, we need to combine all the forces. And to do that, we need to check a very initial stage at the universe where all the forces were combined into a single singularity. But during inflation, these all symmetries or all the forces separated. So what I have researched, it was given that at that time, electromagnetic and the strong nuclear forces separated, and which caused inflation of the universe. And this is what we call as the breaking of symmetry. Great. And then after, as you can look today, we have the smooth expansion of the universe. However, there is one more point I would like to introduce to you, that many people get confused between the expansion and the inflation. Okay, considering they both are the same stuff, like even inflation regards the expansion of the universe, and expansion regards the expansion of the universe. But what is the main key difference between those two words? So inflation basically happens in the constant of the time. Okay, so time is what matters in the difference of these two words. In inflation, the universe expands so humongously with a very less time. And in the case of expansion, the universe expands at a comparatively smaller distance in a huge amount of time. I would also like to explain this with a graph, which I have drawn here. This graph, as you can see in this graph, the time is on the y-axis, and the space, or the expansion basically, is on the x-axis. Okay. So, and r basically denotes here the rate of the expansion, which is represented by the gray area over here. This area where I have written inflation. You can notice that when the t was tending to zero, that means at this point, the universe was just started to expand, or let us say it has started the process of inflation, and you can see it has inflated so largely in a very short amount of time. So let us say in just dt, okay, that is a very small amount of time, the universe has expanded very humongously. That is, let us say s, okay. And then after that, it is now today, it is expanding. That is, it has increased its radius. If we consider it as a closed universe, it has increased its radius in a very short, long amount of time. Okay, so this rate of expansion of the universe can also be given with this equation, where r is the rate of expansion, which equals the s is basically the expanded radius of the universe, or the distance between two mutual points in the universe, which has increased the distance between them, and t is basically the time period it took for those two mutual points to expand or to get farther away from each other. One more thing I would like you to visualize is through this video, and I don't know about any source which can explain you so accurately rather than this video. Okay. Yeah. So here is that video. Now in this video, you will see how this balloon inflates at the beginning, and then it expands at the end of its stage. Okay, so the space within that balloon should be imagined as our universe itself. So now I will play the video and you just have a look on it. Now at this point, the balloon is just expanding because the space is getting freed away with a very huge period of time. However, here the balloon basically inflated because it has expanded very humongously in a very short amount of time. So this is what basically known as the inflation of the universe. So this is how universe inflated. Now how can it solve the problem? So basically, before telling the solution of the problem, I would like you to explain what does that problem mean. Now going ahead, I would also like you to know the cosmological constant. So this cosmological constant was basically not there in this equation when it was the belief that the universe is static. But as soon as the scientists know that the universe came to know that the universe is expanding, they put this cosmological constant, or basically we can say that the Einstein, Sir Albert Einstein, put this cosmological constant, which he thought to be his greatest error. But actually it helps scientists today to eliminate some errors in their readings with the experiment regarding the universal expansion. Now, the first problem which I would be considering here is the horizon problem. Now, what does this problem say? I hope you have learned about the transfer of heat, okay, the concept of the transfer of heat. In that, we have learned about three concepts. The heat can be transferred through conduction, it can be transferred through induction, and it can be transferred through radiation. Now we know that in today's phase of the universe, there is a complete vacuum, or the most of the universe is an empty void, or it is a vacuum. So conduction and induction are the bad choices. However, we have radiation. So we have radiation, but radiation cannot reach from one point to any other points. Now here I have considered two mutual points, point A and point B. Let us consider point A over here, and here we have point B. Now let us say a photon with certain temperature, okay, or taking certain temperature or energy, okay, we will say as energy. It took a certain energy with it, and it is traveling towards B, point B, which is at a huge distance from point A, due to the expansion or the inflation of the universe. but this photon can never reach B in the phase of radiation. Why so? Here I would like you to consider an escalator. Now you might have seen the escalator in malls, and you might have used them too. Now imagine yourself standing on an escalator which is moving downwards, and you want to go from point A. Okay, here is point A, and here are you. And you want to go to point B, which is upwards, but escalator is moving downwards. Now your velocity of traveling towards B is, let us say, v, and the velocity with which escalator is moving downwards is basically v prime. Here v prime is greater than v, so you can never travel further from point A, because before you take your next step and displace a bit, the escalator will put you back on point A. And this was the same case happened during the inflation. During the inflation, what happened is that when point A and point B were expanding, they were expanding with a tremendous velocity, okay, which outweigh the speed of light. But wait a minute, the theory of relativity basically says that no one can outweigh the speed of light, and no one can travel faster than this. So how is it so? The answer to this is the density. Let us say point A is here and point B is here, and they are just expanding with certain velocity. And here is a dense matter, because we all know that when the universe was a very tiny point, it was so dense. So the light would obviously refract due to this density, and the speed of the light will become slower a bit. And we all know that this is because of the particles like Higgs boson or Higgs field. So due to which light traveled a bit slower, and relatively the speed of expansion or the rate of inflation got larger as compared to the speed of light, and thus the heat never reached from one point to another point due to the radiation too. So that's why we don't have conduction as any method of heat transfer. We don't have induction as any method of heat transfer. We don't even have the radiation as any method of heat transfer. So how will the universe become homogeneous? Because by the time we had the microwave background, we know that the sum of the temperature in the universe is basically 2.17 Kelvin. Okay, approximately 2.17 Kelvin. But how could the universe reach such an equilibrium of the temperature when the light could not reach, or the radiation could not reach, from point A to point B? So the inflation theory here comes in the picture and answers this in such a way that it assumes point A and point B to be infinitely closer. Okay, let us say this is at the Planck's distance. This is the Planck's distance, and no distance can be smaller than this. So let us say this distance between A and B is 6.63 into 10 raised to minus 34. So this is basically distance of A and B, and the speed of light we all know is c, which is equal to 10 raised to 8 meters per second. So for the light to cover this such a smaller distance is just a piece of a cake. So in the initial stage of the universe, I mean before the Big Bang, the energy just transferred from point A to point B, covering such a smaller distance. And in this way, the heat was transferred through radiation, and due to the density, okay, the density between A and B, the heat transferred through conduction and even through induction. So in these three ways, the heat transferred from point A to point B, making this portion homogeneous. And this happened with this portion, and similarly every portion of the universe. And in such a and in this way, universe ultimately became it came into state of the equilibrium, a thermal equilibrium. And today we see the temperature of the microwave background as approximately 2.17 Kelvin. It might be even lesser than that, but we took the approximate value of it. Great. So in this way, the inflation theory addresses the first problem, which was the horizon problem, or how the temperature of the universe is same at every point. Great. Now, moving to further problem, that is a flatness of the universe, I would like you to firstly know the theory of general relativity in its visual circumstances. So how do we visualize the theory of general relativity? It says that let sun be in the center of this fabric, and let this fabric be a trampoline. Let us say the sun is in the center of this fabric. This is the sun, and the earth is here. Now, because the sun created a space-time curve or a bulge in this trampoline, the earth revolved around the sun. However, to visualize it a bit further, I would like you to show a video. A great experiment. I love this experiment, and I hope you will like it. So how this professor throws these small marbles towards a black, let us say magnet, I guess it is, but towards a heavier mass, and how these marbles revolved to that heavier mass as the planets, and be that mass be our sun. So this is how the planet revolved around this heavier mass. But this can only happen when our universe will be a flat trampoline. But that is basically not the case here. Okay, as we know that our universe is three-dimensional. It is a sphere. We know that the universe is a sphere. But still, I have drawn here a circle, and I have drawn a flat line on that circle. Let us say, okay. So what it did, it changed this two-dimensional circle into one-dimensional thing. I'll just move on to explain you, and you will get the answer by yourself. Further from this, I would also like you to show a simulation in Desmos. So here, if I will zoom out this diagram, you can see that this diagram is becoming a very huge parabola. Now, considering our universe is flat, is nothing but changing a three-dimensional universe into a two-dimensional universe. Okay, from three-dimensional x, y, z to just two-dimensional x, y. So with that analogy, this parabola, which is two-dimensional geometric figure, should convert into one dimension. And we all know that while two dimensions are the four direction, one dimension is only one direction. Either you can move like this, either you can move like this. Here, this will represent a horizontal line through this parabola. Now, when I will zoom in, okay, now I have zoomed in at a greater extent. And here you can see for a very, very, very tiny speck on this parabola, I can mark these two points at negative 0.01 and at positive 0.01, where this parabola has converted or has displayed its one-dimensional nature. So in the similar way, when we look at a very tiny speck in this universe, we cannot basically visualize a 3D nature of this universe, but the universe shows us its two-dimensional nature. And this is what the inflation theory explains in a simple manner, that because the humans are living in a very short or in a very small region of the space, they assume this universe or this space to be flat. And thus, we consider the gravity. When we consider the gravity as theory, we talk about the space-time curve and the trampoline and a higher mass and a lower mass, for example, marbles. In this case, so because we live in or we observe very small speck of the universe or in the universe, we assume universe to be a flat, but actually universe is not a flat system, and thus the flatness problem should basically not exist on such a huge scale. But However, this is the reason which inflation theory basically gives us. So moving ahead, I can take you to this diagram where this person lives in such a small speck of the universe. Over here, it says that the universe is flat, or it assumes that the universe is flat. But basically, when I, being a three-dimensional being, I could see this whole universe, I can see that this universe is not one-dimensional. So contradicting the idea of this person, I can say that the that his universe is basically two-dimensional, because I could see his universe as a whole. But if I would be that person, I can say that the universe is not two-dimensional, but basically a one-dimensional. And applying this analogy to myself, because I'm living or observing to a very, very, very small speck of the universe, I can say that the universe is not three-dimensional. Rather, I could assume that the universe is a two-dimensional trampoline or a two-dimensional fiber. And that's what Einstein did while giving his general theory of relativity. And with that said, here I end my presentation. I thank you all to patiently listen this. And I hope that you all would like it. Thank you.